The food web in an aquarium is such that every single living creature in the aquarium is feeding off of some other product that's being produced by other living creatures in the aquarium. And there's a chain in which this works. Everything is interdependent upon everything else.
Well, hello. Come right on in. You're at Father Fish.
Is your aquarium a living garden? Is life at every level of the aquarium? Certainly you have fish, perhaps some snails, some other invertebrates, but do you have microfauna? Do you have a wide variety of bacteria? Do you have life at every single level of your aquarium? If you do, then you have a living aquarium, and one that is in balance with itself. If you do not have a living aquarium, then you have levels in your aquarium that are sterile, and as such, they are by definition toxic. Trying to maintain a sterile aquarium is the simplest way to create a toxic environment. You see, toxins are not only substantial excesses of nutrients or minerals, primarily metal-type minerals. Toxic can also be the complete lack of life in a given strata. And those who use chemicals and other additives, a harsh medication in your aquarium, that have the effect of killing, whether it's algae or bacteria or some pathogen, you would be killing off all sorts of living creatures that are in that environment that are helping to balance and sustain it. So by putting a harsh medication in your aquarium, you're creating layers of death. You're creating a toxic environment. A natural aquarium is one in which the substrate and the water, the plants, the fish, and everything else are living in harmony with each other. They are, in fact, interdependent upon each other. In point of fact, they feed each other. The food web in an aquarium is such that every single living creature in the aquarium is feeding off of some other product that's being produced by other living creatures in the aquarium, if only by their death, but more typically by their waste. A plant produces waste, which for animals is nutrients. Animal produces waste, which for plants and most forms of microfauna is nutrition. And there's a chain in which this works, a process, a web in which this works, in which everything is interdependent upon everything else. And the more you put in that environment, the greater the interdependence becomes. And you do this by adding natural items to it, such as leaves, the dried leaves that fall from trees. They are the fundamental food source in all of the river and stream systems, even the lake systems. All of these moving bodies of water are absolutely dependent on the leaves of trees as their basic nutrient, out of which all sorts of things grow and thrive, going in both directions, to the smallest and to the largest. They depend on this, so you want to add this. And when you do, add some from a living body of water so that you will be bringing the organisms into your aquarium that are needed in order to be able to maintain this balance. So that's basically it. Do this incrementally. Do it slowly and do it gradually. You don't need to dump a whole bunch in all at once. Take your time, and you will build an environment in which your small fish are going to be feeding on that environment for 100% of their needs. They will spawn in it, and their babies will grow in that same environment. Larger fish will still gain the benefit of it. Don't forget, a fish 5 inches long sees items for food that we can't see with our eyes. They are that much smaller than we are. And there are many different kinds of macrofauna that live in this environment that even our larger fish can enjoy. There's a notion going about that excess nutrient necessarily creates a foul environment. That is true only up to a point. It is true if you suddenly dump a vast amount of nutrition into a given environment, it will create a foul condition because the bacteria will attack it and they will build up, drive the oxygen level down, and wind up creating a serious problem for oxygen-related animals. Oh, the algae will do great. And eventually it will overcome that difficulty, providing there is not a continuous source of excess nutrients. The process of life overcomes adversity by assimilating that which is in the environment. That's precisely what happens in your aquarium. It creates a balance, and the longer that balance exists, the more stable it becomes. The aquarium behind me is 22 years old. A year or two ago, someone dumped a can of food in that tank while it was at my shop. I saw it about 2 days later. It was pretty messy. I siphoned off a little bit, used my net, and got most of the waste that was out of it. Dropped the level down about 15%, maybe 20%, refilled it, hooked up the filters, and let it crank. And within 2 days, it was crystal clear and fine. It had absorbed and assimilated even that excess amount of nutrient that was put in the tank. And that's the way these systems work. That's the way nature works. Nature always has the victory, always. It has for billions of years, and there's nothing we can do to change that. So give this a go. Make a serious effort to create a living environment. Lots of videos, lots of resources that we've developed to help you find the ways to do this. And there's even a channel, the Father Fish Shoal, which is a Discord channel that will provide many, many opportunities for conversation and support, help, assistance, ideas, praise and wonders galore. Do join us as we work together to build in our homes an understanding of the nature of nature and how nature thrives in all of its aspects. Join us for the joy of this. Love you all. Bye for now.